Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. Now, I'm happy and excited, but a tiny bit cross as well. I'll tell you for why. I've got St. Peter's, lovely brewery, beautiful brewery, St. Peter's Cream Stout. As I show you around the bowl. 6.5 ABV. And they'll tell you all about the history of what is the headquarters of the brewery. I'm not sure if it's the actual brewery itself. What I like, they listed the hops here, Fuggles and Challenger. Lovely, proper British hops. Now, the Fuggles is usually a bittering hop, 99% of the time. There are people like our Martin from Panther Brewery, who use it also as a kind of a late hop as well, which is like an aroma hop. And to put it to quite good use, which is bucking the trend, and I love that. I love things that buck the trend, because I'm not one of the conformers, you know. I'm a bit of a black sheep and that, you know. Anyway, back to the beer. One thing, I mean, I do love the bottle here. I do love all these bits and pieces on the bottle, but what happened to the medicine shaped bottle? This is medicine shaped bottle. Used to be was kind of like squeezed in a bit, was like like an old medicine bottle. It was oval shaped, sort of like that. And I think they still do that with the Ruby L and things and whatever, but getting a bit frightened that this is a round one. Still looks nice, broad shoulder, kind of square shouldered and that, you know. You know, I'm one of these people. I'm such a traditionalist, but that I get frightened by any sort of change, you know, old fashioned, I suppose. Right, and yet I do like things to kind of move on and change as well, so strange, isn't it? I'm either schizophrenic or two-faced, one or the other. You make your own mind up. Don't tell me though. Right. Slight scratch in it, slight dent, but very lovely one there. The Raven and the Key there, I'm not sure what that's all about. Ravens usually guardians, in the way that they are guardians in the Tower of London. And keys are usually to do with faith and stuff and churches and all that. So, probably to do with St. Peter's. St. Peter was the one that was hung upside down, because he didn't want to be hung the same way as Christ and everything else. So I'm not religious, I just kind of seem to learn this stuff. I'm going to get a clean glass, because I've used that for another one. Someone's been doing a bit of gardening again. Get on with it. While I'm kind of just cleaning this up on my shirts, because I didn't bring any tea towels in like I usually do, that's better. Cream stout, milk stouts. You've got lactic, what they call the lactose, the sugar from milk, derived from milk. Now the yeast that break down many other different sugars, from sucrose to glucose and all sorts of other sugars, that are around in the malts, and even if you pour in some white sugar or whatever, you know, the processed sugars, the yeast will have a go at those, but it doesn't kind of break down the lactose. So any milk stouts and cream stouts are usually a little bit sweeter. So this for me has already got a breakdown of even though it's a kind of an InBev drink, and a big kind of mass-produced one nowadays, I suppose. It used to be a smaller one, but it's got break ground with Mackeson Stout for me. Mackeson and Cream Label was ones that I had almost grew up with. I I had them poured in my bottle when I was a baby. I know, it's nowadays you go, what? But, you know, it made me sleep. I was a screamy little shit. Nothing's changed. There you go. Now, hopefully I don't want to pour Ed on this. Don't be looking for Ed, but I think there's... No, I think I managed to get away with it. Gratuitous headshot in the corner there. I'm going to start including it. I'm going to get a picture of the Fosters or something like that, or the sweet SFA. SFA, the summer skills one, where I had a whole pint of head. And that was it. Anyway, look, quick, get the head wise there. It's actually made its own head as well. And for those that like it described, it's creamy coloured, creamy brown sort of colour. And now, get a receipt, hold it the other side, dark. Give me a little torch, hold it the other side, bring me a torch. Just move that and put it in there. Oh. That is quite, really dark. Hardly anything going on there, that's a really bright torch. Smell. I've been a bit disappointed. I don't know if it's because I've got a slight cold. I don't know if it's that. But I've been a little bit disappointed with my smells tonight. I've had all dark ones tonight. I've had an Asahi. I had a Navigate Old Growler. And I've just had having St. Peter's Cream Stout. And I've hardly smelt anything tonight. I'm hoping it's just maybe I've got a slight bit of flu. Not getting a lot. Oh, yeah. Sorry. I'm just going off the point here. God, blimey, I'm running out of time. I watched a young lady doing beer reviews on here. What's it taste of? It tastes of beer. She's done about five or six like that. It tastes like beer. You think, what are you doing? Sorry. I don't listen. I don't have a go at other people. Even ones like that. I don't have a go at other people's reviews. I really don't. But it just makes me laugh, you know. Right, drink. That's delicious. That's nice. It's nice, it's really nice. It's got a little bit of nuttiness to it. There's a coffee edge there, there's lovely sweet sort of creamy, almost that almost evaporated milk creaminess in there without the thickness of it. But there's a metallic taste in there as well. But I think that will kind of, sometimes you get that metallic taste, and it's the bitterness of a Fuggles hop. Or, you know, there's Fuggles and Challenger in there. Which is lovely, you know, they tell you. And you can kind of just taste them in there now. I don't know how some of them marry together, but I would have a look at different hops. Pardon me, excuse me. good lord. Yeah, I'd have a look at different hops myself. It's really nice. And, yep, I'd say go for it. Give it a try. But at the same time, you've got to bear in mind, you can pick up Macs and Stout in them little cans for about something that works out about £1 a can. I don't know how much these little cans are. But four of them for like £4, sometimes less. I think a bit better, a bit more flavour in them. So I would say, because of that nutty background, that kind of soft cashewy sort of background, I would say definitely try it. But at the same time, you got to think of that alongside Max and Stout, which is a mass produced sort of beer, a mass producer in Bev and that, and at the same time, it's InBev are looking after Mackeson Stouts. Ain't messed it up too much. They've gone slightly more metallic nowadays. But they're still a lovely, lovely beer. So, me personally, go and try it once. Let me know what you think. But I don't think I'd buy a big cotchel of them. If you want a big cotchel and you like a sweet stout, Max and Stout's for you. Cheers, guys. Bye. Do you like when I do that? Bye. I'm trying to stop doing it. So I'm going to try not to go bye. I don't know, it's just me. Anyway.